Yeah. Exciting news, Jeremy. My segment's back.
Oh, God, not Hilary Helps, please.
Yeah, I took all your feedback on board about how I actually don't help people, which I think I did, but anyway. Tonight, I've got one that's going to help everyone.
That's a big call.
So everybody, every 3 hours, a house fire in New Zealand breaks out. So it's vital you know what to do to get out alive. Fire and Emergency New Zealand is launching Escape Week to get families to take a few minutes to make a life-saving escape plan. Tonight on Hilary Helps, we're at the Davis House and we're going to see if they've got a fire escape plan. I'm all set. I've got my megaphone, I've got my whistle, I've got my stopwatch and I've got my clipboard. Come on. Hi, everybody. Sorry to interrupt. Lovely to meet you. I'm Hilary.
Hi, Hilary. I'm Laura.
Yes, that's Mum Laura, Dad Garth and their kids, 7-year-old Boston, 5-year-old Millen and 2-year-old Kaya.
Before we get underway, have you got some smoke alarms?
Yes, we do.
How many of those have you got?
2 up currently, but we've got some which aren't up at the moment because we're renovating.
Now, the other thing I need to ask you too is, do you have an escape plan?
Well, we have talked about it briefly, haven't we?
Kind of.
Do you feel like we have a plan?
Yeah, kind of, probably.
Well, kind of and probably sounds pretty good to me. Shall we put it to the test?
Yeah.
Shall we? Yeah! Come on!
For the purposes of this drill, we're going to pretend it's the middle of the night and everyone's asleep in bed.
There's been a fire. A fire has broken out. Escape the house now. Wake up!
If you stay low, you'll avoid the smoke. Just a few breaths of it can kill you.
Quick, wake up, darling. There's a fire.
Close doors. A closed door buys you time. It'll slow down the spread of the fire, giving you more time to get out.
You cannot come in here. I am the fire. The fire is in the kitchen.
If the first way out is blocked by fire, you'll need an alternative escape, maybe out the window.
Get out and stay out.
Don't take anything with you. Leave it all behind. Your life is more important.
Where is your meeting place? This is too close. You are too close to the house.
Over to the sign.
Okay, and I'm stopping the clock. So the amazing thing is, you guys got out in about 1 minute and 20 seconds. You only have about 3 minutes to get out of the house, and you guys managed to do it that quickly. So that is fantastic.
A good result. But what could they have done better?
We needed to be further away from the house when we got out. Now we know that we've got that further away meeting point.
Do the small children in your family, I'm thinking of Kaya, know that they've got to wait for Mummy and Daddy to come and get them?
Knowing her, I feel like she would wait, although that probably is something that we do need to talk to her more about. That's a microphone. Because you never really know how they're going to react in the actual event of an emergency.
Okay, one other thing, and that is obstacles. I mean, we saw you tripping over the plastic bike.
That there.
And that's what happens when you have children in the household. Do you think you might think about that before going to bed in the future?
Tidy up time. We need to start doing that again.
Well, there's something here that might be able to help you. Escape my house, because that will actually help you with some of that planning.
Oh, that's really cool. I didn't even know that existed. Be fast, get low, close doors. I didn't
that
get low.
Sounds a lot like what Hilary was saying.
The Davises now have a new and improved escape plan. And I'm pretty sure the next time I pop round, they might have shaved a few more seconds off their time.
So great job. Great job. Well done, Mum and Dad. You saved your family. So it actually might be a good idea to take a few minutes now to create your escape plan at home. You can go to escapemyhouse.co.nz. One big thing to remember too, always keep keys and deadlocks on doors and windows when you're at home so that you can get out quickly. You might think it's easy to find a key, but in a fire you'll probably be scared and disorientated, and the smoke might make it hard to breathe and see clearly. So that's something you could do right now.
Tell you what's terrifying, you with a megaphone. Telling people to get away, get back, get back. They'll be having nightmares about that, not the fire.
Did I help?
Yes, no, you did help.
Thank you.
No, you actually did help. Sorry, I'm nitpicking there.